Welcome. The Office of the Chief Data Officer and the Texas Department of Information Resources are proud to offer this course on data ethics. During this course, we will discuss ethical principles related to creating, managing, sharing, using, and disposing of data. By the end of this course, you'll be able to understand different aspects or tenets of data ethics, and understand the kinds of questions you should ask yourself when handling data throughout its life cycle. Ethics are principles of behavior based on ideas of right and wrong, and these principles often focus on concepts such as fairness, respect, integrity, transparency, and trust. Data ethics are the norms of behavior that promote appropriate judgments and accountability when creating, managing, sharing, using, and disposing of data. While data may seem as if it is merely technical information, its use must be guided by ethical principles, or it will present a risk to an organization's success. All employees of Texas state agencies and institutions of higher education are accountable for ethical data handling and preserving privacy with an appropriate level of transparency. The ethical use of data focuses on several core concepts. Impact on people. Data represents characteristics of individuals and is used to make decisions that affect people's lives, so we must manage its quality and reliability. Potential for misuse. We must prevent the misuse of data, because misusing data can negatively affect people and organizations. And economic value. Because data has an economic value, it is imperative to determine how that value can be accessed and by whom. As employees of Texas state agencies and institutions of higher education, it is our responsibility to have a foundational understanding of the basic tenets of data ethics that go beyond these core concepts, so we may practice ethical behaviors when working with data. The Federal Data Strategy outlines 7 tenets around the ethical use of data, and each tenet should be considered at every stage of the data lifecycle, from the creation or acquisition of data, to processing data and using it to make business decisions, and even when disposing of data. Let's explore these tenets now. The first tenet of data ethics is to uphold applicable statutes, regulations, professional practices, and ethical standards. Existing laws reflect and reinforce ethics. Therefore, information producers and consumers should adhere to all applicable laws and regulations, many of which are discussed in the Texas Data Literacy Program course on data privacy. Each organization's data governance program should establish its own standards and policies regarding the ethical handling of data specific to the organization. Imagine you're a data analyst working for a large Texas state agency. You have access to confidential information about the agency's clients and employees. One day, you're approached by a friend who runs a small business and is in desperate need of information about a potential client. Your friend offers to pay you for the information, and now you're faced with a dilemma. While you could always use the extra money, you know that sharing confidential information would be a violation of your agency's policies and could even be illegal. In this scenario, choosing to uphold applicable statutes, regulations, professional practices, and ethical standards would mean declining your friend's offer and protecting the confidential information. This would demonstrate your commitment to following the laws and ethical principles as a data analyst, as well as protecting the rights of the agency's clients and employees. You should be aware that data-related activity can be lawful, yet still be unethical. In other words, legal compliance does not always guarantee and enforce ethical behavior. Which leads us to the second tenet, respect the public, individuals, and communities. Data users may collect, use, or share data legally, but when analyzing and making decisions based on that data, they must be aware of any potential negative consequences to people, the community, or the environment due to issues such as incomplete data, misinterpretation of results, or underlying biases and discrimination. Data activities should have the overarching goal of benefiting the public good, and responsible use of data begins with careful consideration of its potential impacts. Data initiatives should include considerations for unique community and local contexts, and have an identified and clear benefit to society. Let's say you're a data scientist tasked with proposing improvements to the public transportation system in a big city. Excited about the opportunity to make a positive impact, you gather some data on bus and train routes and schedules, along with information on who uses the transport system and when. As you delve into the data, you realize that the bus routes serving low-income neighborhoods are less frequent and less reliable compared to those serving wealthier areas. Remembering data ethics, you meet with your supervisor, present your findings, and propose solutions to make the transportation system more equitable for everyone. Here are some questions to consider as you work with data. Are you familiar with the laws, regulations, and ethical standards related to the data you use? Are there any underlying biases in the data collected that might have a negative impact or increase inequalities among certain populations or cultures? What are the potential benefits and drawbacks of using the data for a specific purpose? What would be the harm in excluding or not using certain data in your analysis? What are the environmental implications of the project, and how might risks be mitigated? The third tenet of data ethics is to respect privacy and confidentiality. Privacy and confidentiality should always be protected in a manner that respects the dignity, rights, and freedom of data subjects. In this context, privacy is the state of being free from unwarranted intrusion into the private life of individuals, and confidentiality is the state of one's information being free from inappropriate access, disclosure, and misuse. An essential objective of privacy and confidentiality protection is to minimize potential negative consequences through measures such as comprehensive risk assessments, disclosure avoidance, and upholding data governance standards, policies, and procedures. Imagine you work for an agency that manages personal health records for millions of patients. And one day, a coworker asks you to access the health records of a local celebrity to see what kind of treatments they have been receiving. You decline and remind your coworker about the importance of keeping patient information confidential and only accessing it for legitimate and authorized purposes. Breaking this trust can have serious legal and ethical consequences, but by upholding data ethics, you and your colleague ensure that the personal information of millions of patients remains protected. The fourth tenet of data ethics is to act with honesty, integrity, and humility. All data users are expected to exhibit honesty and integrity in their work with data, regardless of job title, role, or data responsibilities. Employees should not perform or condone unethical data behaviors. When sharing data and findings, employees should report information accurately and present any data limitations and known biases. All sources and methods used to obtain and analyze data, including any pre-processing, should be fully disclosed, and detailed explanations should be provided for any exclusions. Information producers and consumers are expected to exhibit humility when presenting data. Be open to feedback, and when possible, invite discussion with the public. Imagine your organization manages a lot of sensitive customer information. And one day, your manager asks you to alter a customer activity report to make the organization look a little bit better. As a data professional, you know this goes against data ethics. You remind your manager it is the organization's ethical responsibility to maintain the accuracy of the information, and altering the report would be a breach of the customer's trust. Presenting the report as it is, even if it doesn't reflect the best results for the organization, is the right choice because the customer's trust is more valuable in the long run. You also remind your manager that being open to feedback provides opportunities for the organization to make improvements. Here are some questions to consider as you work with data. Are you using data only for its explicitly defined and appropriate use? Could the data be combined with other data sets that could increase the risk of violating an individual's privacy and confidentiality? When presenting the results of an analysis, have you provided clear notes describing what data is included, as well as what data has been excluded and why? Have you presented information in a way that could be misunderstood or doesn't portray a complete or accurate picture? The fifth tenet of data ethics is to hold oneself and others accountable. Accountability requires that anyone working with or using data at any point in the data lifecycle be aware of and responsible to any and all stakeholders. Stakeholders may include data providers, such as research subjects or persons receiving state-provided services, or data consumers, such as internal or external customers requesting data and information. Accountability includes the responsible handling of classified and controlled information, upholding data use agreements made with data providers and consumers, minimizing data collection, informing individuals and organizations of the potential uses of their data, and allowing for public access, amendment, and contestability to data and findings where appropriate. Let's say one of your colleagues approaches you and asks for some confidential customer data that you have access to, but you know that sharing this information without a legal data sharing agreement in place would be a violation of your organization's privacy policy of handling classified and controlled information. Your colleague says they need the data quickly for a very important project, and they don't have time to wait for the legal documents to be created and approved. It's your responsibility to act with integrity and follow the rules, even if it means going against a colleague, so you decline the request. You explain why you can't provide the data and remind your colleague of their responsibility for demonstrating ethical behavior. Your colleague is frustrated at first, but understands and respects your decision. By upholding the data ethics tenet of accountability, you protect your organization's reputation and the privacy of its customers, but you also demonstrate your own ethical character and commitment to doing the right thing. The sixth tenet of data ethics is to promote transparency. Individuals, organizations, and communities benefit when the decision-making process is as transparent as possible to stakeholders. Transparency depends on clear communication of all aspects of data activities throughout the entire data lifecycle. Promoting transparency requires engaging stakeholders through easily accessible feedback channels and providing timely updates on the progress and outcomes of data use. Transparency also includes standard processes and documentation when correcting previously reported data that might contain errors, including providing explanations of what was inaccurate and how it was corrected. Imagine you're a data analyst, and while analyzing some customer data for trends that could help improve the organization's provision of services, you realize that some of the information is missing. Instead of just ignoring it, you decide to bring this to your boss's attention. You explain how the missing data could potentially impact the accuracy of your analysis. Your boss agrees, and together you come up with a plan to be transparent about the missing data in your final report. You include a note explaining that some data was missing and the potential impact it could have on the analysis and on any business decisions made based on the analysis. You also suggest ways to gather more complete data in the future. By promoting transparency, you're doing the right thing ethically. You are making sure the analysis is as accurate and trustworthy as possible, and acknowledging the limitations allows you to plan for more complete analyses in the future. Here are some questions to consider as you work with data. Does a data sharing agreement or other legal document need to be in place to share or release the data? Could sharing confidential data with another organization have a negative impact on individuals or communities? Does the data you are collecting need to be collected in the first place? Are the rights of individuals balanced against the need for transparency? Are you deleting or disposing of data in accordance with the appropriate records retention schedule? The seventh and final tenet of data ethics is to stay informed of developments in the fields of data management and data science. Advanced technologies can provide great benefits to the public sector, but should be deployed with a commitment to accountability and risk mitigation. Organizations are increasingly using interactive visualization tools to present data and tell their data stories, and visualizations of the data should be designed in such a way to minimize the risk of misinterpretation. In planning such projects or analyses, it is also critical to make sure the data feeding these visualization tools is secure, and analytic tools should be configured in such a way that unauthorized users will not be able to download sensitive, confidential, or protected data, either intentionally or by accident. New data innovations emerge every day with the potential to deliver insights more efficiently and effectively. It is important for data users to remain informed of developments in the fields of data management and data science because advanced methods impact future data collection, management, and use. Thorough documentation and governance of reference and master data, metadata, and security classifications are essential for protecting sensitive, confidential, and regulated data from unauthorized or unethical use. The use of more advanced and emerging technologies requires deliberate awareness and oversight as they are often based on considerable amounts of data and employ complex algorithms which can increase opportunities for risk, such as privacy and security breaches, or even misinterpretations of results based on incomplete or poor quality data. Let's say you are the director of a client service delivery program within your organization, and you are excited about the possibilities offered by artificial intelligence and machine learning tools to inform and drive improvements in service delivery. You know that advanced analytics algorithms are based on vast amounts of data, so the quality of the data must be high to get accurate results. You also know it is essential to prioritize human-centered approaches to the development and use of these emergent technologies to reduce bias, increase transparency, and uphold other ethical tenets. You realize that the fields of data management and data science are constantly evolving, and new techniques and tools are being developed all the time. To make sure you understand the appropriate and ethical use of these new techniques and tools, you make it a point to stay informed of the latest developments in the field by subscribing to industry newsletters and attending conferences and workshops to network with data professionals and learn about new trends and best practices in the field. By staying informed, you are enhancing your ability to make better business decisions using the most up-to-date technologies possible, while also reducing bias, increasing transparency, and upholding other ethical tenets. Here are some questions to consider as you work with data. What happens when artificial intelligence and machine learning efforts are based on poor quality data, or if the quality of the data isn't defined at all? What happens when the efforts are based upon biased or incomplete data? How might that impact business decisions based on artificial intelligence and machine learning efforts? You have now completed the Texas Data Literacy Program course on data ethics. We hope you have found this information useful. As employees of Texas state agencies and institutions of higher education, it is our responsibility to be good stewards of our data and information. To ensure you are using data ethically, discuss questions such as those posed in this course with your teams, leadership, and stakeholders on a regular basis. This aids in the due diligence required from an ethical standpoint. If you have any questions about any of the ethical tenets presented here in this course, please consult your organization's legal counsel. You should now have a better understanding of the different aspects or tenets of data ethics, and the kinds of questions you should ask yourself when handling data throughout its life cycle. For more information on data governance and data management principles, visit the Office of the Chief Data Officer website,